Hello, my name is Nikos Mouzakis, and I'm going to present our paper titled Node Maxhat and Computing Equilibria in Linear Weighted Congestion Games. This is joint work with Dimitris Fotakis, Vardis Kandiros, Thanasis Lianeas, Panagios Pasilinakos, and Satis Koulakis. A recurring problem in computer science is finding solution to problems when the solution is somehow already guaranteed to exist. To capture the complexity of such problems, Megido Papadimitriou defined the complexity class TFNP. In this class, are contained all the class where the solution is somehow guaranteed to exist and can be easily recognized. In fact, in such problems, the theory of NP completeness cannot help us, since we would be able to construct both yes and no certificates for every NP complete problem, meaning NP equals co-NP and the subsequent collapsless polynomial hierarchy. The problems in TFNP are further categorized based on the combinatorial principle that guarantees the existence of a solution. Since we're dealing with promise problems, it must be possible to recognize the totality of a problem in polynomial time. The principles that guarantee such existence are diverse. More specifically, TFNPs are divided into the following classes. PBP captures problems where the existence is guaranteed by some sort of pigeonhole collision principle. The class PPA contains problems related to the Hantzsch lemma, while PPAD contains is at the intersection of these two classes and captures the difficulty of finding Brouwer fixed points. PLS captures the hardness of local search and finding local optima and equilibrium. One of the most famous problems in TFNP is that of TAS, which is contained in PPAD and so on hard for this class. While that one of its most celebrated results, TFNP has done substantial active research in recent years, and researchers find more and more connections to other subfields of mathematics and computer science. And its ranks are constantly growing, with more and more complete problems or not added to it. In this talk, we are going to focus on the class PLS, where the existence is guaranteed by proof by potential function. In this case, the solution required is usually a local minimizer of some potential, or can be found as a result of some local chess algorithm, as its namesake implies. All problems in PLS can be equivalently viewed as a directed acyclic graph, where every solution corresponds to a vertex of that graph. Moreover, we require that the problem possesses some efficient neighborhood structure, so we can calculate the improving solution efficiently. An acceptable solution to our PLS problem is at least one of the things that are guaranteed to exist in the graph. Some of the most celebrated problems contained in this class include potential games or also congestion games, as well as the local maxcat problem. Perhaps the simplest and most versatile example of PLS complete problem is that of local maxcat. In local maxcat, we are given an edge-weighted graph along with a neighborhood improving function of flipping single vertex as long as it decreases the value of the cat. In other words, we compromise, and instead of asking for the optimal cat, which is a known NP-hard problem, we compromise and ask for a local optimum under the flip heuristic. For example, in this example, this node can change its partition and increase the cat. And this process can repeat indefinitely until the cat reaches its optimal value. This problem was in fact shown by Safran Yannakakis to be PLS complete, meaning it is at least as hard as any other local search problem. Not only is it PLS complete, but also its versatility and elegance has allowed multiple researchers to prove PLS completeness based on local maxcat. It would not be a stretch to say that historically, local maxcat has been to PLS what SAT has been to NP. Another major category of problems that belong in PLS are congestion games. In a congestion game, we have a set of players and a set of resources. Players decide on a set of resources to use based on some set of strategies. Each player experiences a cost, which they want to minimize. This cost is equal to the sum of the latencies they incur. For example, in the case of network congestion games, players want to traverse a graph at the same time. The more players using an edge, the greater the latency they incur. In the case of network congestion games or general congestion games, it was shown by Rosenthal that there exists a global potential function This means that whenever a player improves his cost, there is some global quantity that increases by a commensurate amount. Effectively, this means that this is a local chess problem. To see this, one can consider the potential as the global function that each player takes turn minimizing. Because of the existence of such potential, this means that the existence of an Nash equilibrium is also guaranteed. It is in fact the existence of this potential that places this problem in PLS and casts the local search problem. However, not only are congestion games contained within PLS, but they are also shown to be complete for this class, meaning they are at least as hard as any other local search optimization problem. The computation of a pure Nash equilibrium in this case was shown by Fabricant et al. And subsequently by Ackerman et al. To be PLS hard. In the latter case, a reduction was made from maxcat to network congestion games in the case where players have multiple sources and destinations, called an asymmetric network game, congestion game. In the first work, it was also shown that for the symmetric network case, a maximum flow inspired algorithm can be employed to find a global minimizer of the potential, bypassing any sort of local search in polynomial time. A significant and important generalization of the previous model, which has been investigated a lot, is that of weighted congestion games. In this setting, the players each have a different weight with which they contribute the latency function of each resource. To explain, each player can have their own weight, and there is a potential function on each resource or edge in a network congestion game, which determines based on the sum of the weights of the players using that resource the latency of that edge. However, in this case, it is not clear that the global potential exists. In fact, for the general functions, such a potential does not necessarily exist. However, for certain latencies, such as linear functions of the form a times x plus b, a potential can be defined. Hence, for the case of linear weight congestion games, you can consider them again as a local chess problem, just as their unweighted variant, which places them in PLS. Indeed, the potential found by Fotakis et al. Allows us to prove that an equilibrium must exist. However, in this case, as opposed to the unweighted case, the only assessments we can make regarding its PLS complexity are only those that can be concluded trivially. Specifically, there are many cases of unweighted congestion games where an equilibrium can be computed efficiently and very easily, while the algorithms used do not generalize for weighted congestion games. At the same time, there are no hardened results for this special case of weight congestion games. In this work, we aim to cover this gap by examining the exact impact of the presence of player weights on the complexity of pure Nash equilibrium. Specifically, there are two cases we will be especially interested in. Firstly, congestion game can become easier in the unweighted case due to a simpler topology, especially in the series parallel case. Secondly, if the latency functions themselves are very simple, such as being identity functions. So we're going to examine these two cases where the equilibria are very much easier than the unweighted case. In the first case of series parallel networks, we consider this topology. In the series parallel topology, edges are allowed to be connected either serially or in parallel, similar to a network of resistors. This topology is quite simple, and it has been shown that a number of problems on series parallel graphs can be solved in linear time. For example, series parallel graphs can be recognized in linear time, which shows that series parallel is a very simple topology. Indeed, it was shown by Fotakis that in the case of a series parallel network, a Nash equilibrium can be efficiently computed for unweighted congestion games. In fact, this can be done in polynomial time through a greedy best response algorithm. However, in the weighted case, this algorithm cannot be extended. At the same time, there have been no PLS hardened results covering this case showing hardness here. In this work, we aim to cover this gap, and we in fact show that this problem is PLS complete for weighted congestion games, despite the fact it is simple in the unweighted case. To achieve this, we reduce from local backscat. Essentially, we embed in a series parallel weighted congestion game the structure of local maxcat. The second case we're interested in concerns the case of congestion games with identity delay functions. In this case, any locally improving sequence must make at most polynomial the parameter of the game steps to find. Indeed, since there is nothing exponential either in the latencies or in the players, every path must take at most polynomial steps to end. Indeed, such a problem, there is nothing exponential and the equilibrium can be easily found. However, this is not true for the weighted case, since the exponential difference in the weights of the players can allow any such path to go on for an exponential length of time. Indeed, we saw that computing Nash equilibrium in weight congestion games, where there are only identity delays, this PLS complete. This case is especially interesting to us because we essentially remove any other source of hardness and focus only on the weights of the players. And indeed, we saw that this is enough to be PLS complete. In this case, however, we cannot reduce for local maxcat and instead need to define a new problem to tackle this sub-area of PLS, which we'll explain shortly. Before mentioning the details of the reductions, let us overview our results in this paper. Overall, in these tables, our results concern the complexity of pure Nash equilibrium congestion games. While the only result that generalized from previous work was the unweighted case for asymmetric linear relays, which was again PLS hards in weight congestion games are generalizations for the unweighted case. In our work, we managed to expand the boundaries of PLS hardness through our techniques. First of all, note how series parallel topology games end up being PLS hard while in poly time for the unweighted case. In the same direction, we also find out that when removing all complexity or parameters of the game by removing all the coefficients from the latest functions, the game becomes against PLS complete, even if we only have weighted players. As we said, in the case of identity delays, reducing from local maxcat runs into significant technical difficulties. This is because while only leaving a game with player weights, it becomes very hard to embed a typical maxcat instance in the combinatorial structure of the problem. The structures are essentially incompatible. Indeed, the hardness of local maxcat often comes from the edge, which means this is the interaction between players or nodes. To alleviate this, we define a new problem. The new problem we define is named node maxcat. Just like maxcat denotes the different interaction between players, we define local node maxcat to define the weight of each player. In local node maxcat, we have a vertex weighted rather than edge weighted graph. Every player, or equivalently node, picks a side of the cut based on the total weight of his neighbors on each side. For example, this node prefers to flip, since the total weight of his neighbors on one side is greater. We can, in fact, equivalently consider this problem as a specific instance of local maxcat by setting edge weight equal to the product of the weights on each vertex. Notice now how the value of the cut becomes the potential of the game. This can also be viewed as a weighted potential for this game, where the improvement that each player experiences times their weight is exactly the improvement in potential for its improvement move. This problem is much better suited for reducing to our problem of identity delay functions. Not only is it better suited for this particular application, but also it allows more freedom in getting positive results than classic maxcat. In particular, we can show that there is an efficient algorithm for for computing one plus epsilon approximate equilibria, assuming the different vertex weights are well grouped in a well defined sense, meaning that when we round the weights, if the groups that result are few enough, then we will be able to find efficient quickly in polynomial time one plus epsilon approximate equilibrium. Note that this wouldn't be possible with maxcat, since we only have edge weights in that case instead of node weights, which we're able to sort and order. The main result in this paper is that showing that local node maxcat is in fact PLS complete, despite its seemingly simpler structure. With the help of this result, we're able to show the PLS completeness of network congestion games with identity lays in the asymmetric case. This is an overview of our reductions in this paper. Recall that PLS completeness of series parallel networks is obtained by classical reduction for maxcat. PLS completeness of congestion games where only the players are weighted, however, requires a more delicate approach. PLS completeness in this case is obtained by our novel problem, local node maxcat. The PLS completeness of local node maxcat itself is obtained from a problem called circuit flip, which we'll explain shortly. Again, reducing from local maxcat would not be appropriate, since we cannot embed local maxcat in local node maxcat. Circuit flip was one of the first problems found to be PLS complete by Johnson, Papadimitriou, Giannakakis. An instance of circuit flip consists of a given feedback-free Boolean circuit composed of NOR gates with M input bits and N output bits. Possible solutions are the binary inputs to the circuit, while neighboring solutions are obtained by flipping a single input bit each time. The output of the circuit is considered as the value that we are trying to optimize. Hence, given such a circuit, we are looking for an input value of bits so that flipping any single bit will not decrease or increase the output value, depending on whether we want max circuit flip or min circuit flip. Let us say a few words about the circuit flip to maxcat reduction, highlight some of the technical difficulties involved in this reduction. To start with, we build an existing machinery and previous work by Safir and Giannakakis, Kering Savani, and Telsis and Teusner. Specifically, we construct a vertex redwood graph composed of certain subgraph edges whose role we explain shortly. Here's a high-level depiction of our construction. Essentially, we have two copies of the same subgraph gadget who have the following roles. They each take M input bits and output the two following sets of bits. In the first set, they output the value of the circuit flip problem we're trying to reduce. In the second set of bits, they are outputting the next neighboring solution to that circuit flip problem. The two circuits alternate in their function, constantly giving each other the output of the other. The working principle behind this construction is that these circuits will take turns improving on the solution found by the other gadget until the solution cannot be further improved, which means we will have found a local optimum. Hence, a local optimum of this vertex-weighted graph will give us a local optimum for the local node maxcat instance, for the circuit flip instance. Let us dive a bit deeper into the intricacies of the proof. A key concept related to proof showing PLS hardness of such problems is that of the bias that a node is experiencing, assuming configuration where a node is able to make some improving move. How much he would gain by making this move is called his bias toward the specific value. For example, the red back node here would gain 43 by changing his partition. Conversely, if the node would be unwilling to make this improving move, in total he would lose by making it. This is what we call his bias to remain that position. For example, the node who weights 60 here has bias 43 to remain in that position. Proofs related to circuit flip usually rely on the prototype created by Safir and Giannakakis. On a conceptual level, this gadget has certain nodes named input, output, and control. The control nodes have the property, depending on their value, of controlling the mode in which this gadget is operating. There are two modes. In the first mode, compute mode, the output node is biased to take the NOR value of the input nodes. In the write mode, the two input nodes have no bias. Essentially, the circuit will go from write mode to take the new input into compute mode to compute the new output. In existing circuit flip reductions, these gadgets can be operated simply by setting appropriate edge weights. The problem here in our case is that we need to manipulate possibly very heavy vertices, such as the input nodes, when they have no bias from the gadget, especially when it's on the write mode. To achieve this with only vertex weights, we have to use the following construction. Essentially, the goal is to have a vertex with moderate weight and moderate bias dominate a vertex with high weight but zero bias, such as the input vertices of the Safir and Kahiki gadget. The insight behind this construction is that we can trace bias for weights along the length of the subgraph, effectively allowing us to move the very heavy nodes of the NOR gadgets without having to resort to even heavier vertices, similar to using a lever. Note here that this gadget is unidirectional and cannot possibly be used to emulate completely an edge in a maxcat instance. If that were the case, then we wouldn't have need to bother with circuit flip. Another important technical issue in this reduction is concerning the implementation of comparison error detection. Recall that we have two gadgets that alternatingly take each other's output as their input. The difficulty here is while the circuit with the higher output value must be the one to give its output to the other circuit, we must take care to ensure that it's actually outputting a correct value. In the edge-weighted case, this is achieved by giving the edges related to error detection a much higher weight, and hence priority. In our case, however, each output bit must have a similar weight as the node corresponding to its correctness. The solution here is to analyze the functionality of the comparison more carefully and notice that we don't actually need to ensure the correctness of every lower bit, as long as we have a strict inequality in the higher order bit. For example, in this case where we have a strict inequality in a higher order bit, for example, one higher than zero, we don't need to compare the rest of the lower order bits, even if they're incorrect. In summary, in this presentation, we highlight how PLS hardness can arise even in very simple settings when we add weights to player. We also provide a very simple problem one can use to reason about problems in this setting. Open directions include exploring further the simple structure of local load maxcat, and whether it can be used to give further results even though it's also PLS complete. Moreover, it is also interesting to consider whether our techniques can be extended for symmetric and identity delay games. This problem is where both of our conditions coincide. For example, what happens in series parallel and identity delay games.